does lean forward mean? I think it means heading into the 2012 election, looking forward to what, you know, is in store for the country. There's a lot going on, from the debt ceiling to deficits to the direction the economy is going. There's so much happening in this country right now that a lot of people don't know what it means, what it's about, and the only way you can figure that out is if you go forward, or in the case of MSNBC, lean forward.
We're training with Comcast. I'm the Washington Bureau Chief for the Comcast Network and host of Roll Call TV with Robert Kratom. You know, 15 years ago, I remember Microsoft and NBC coming together to start this new joint venture. This was on the eve of Monica Lewinsky and the impeachment stuff. Republicans had rolled into power. Bill Clinton was on his way out. You know, this was the last 2 years of his term. And I thought to myself, how interesting for NBC and for Microsoft to come together to start this new 24-hour news channel. And lo and behold, 15 years later, MSNBC has been a breath of fresh air. They have brought us entertainment, politics, news, in an insightful way, in a way that has been something that has been literally something that we've been wanting for a long, long time. It's interesting because we didn't know we needed this until MSNBC came along. So thank goodness for MSNBC. They have always been the folks that I've woken up to in the morning in my bedroom. And quite frankly, I don't know if this is too much information, they're the folks that I go to bed to at nighttime. And all throughout the day, whether it's in my office, or perhaps maybe if it's on my iPhone or my PDA, I'm always watching MSNBC because I know they're going to be impartial. I know they're going to give me the most up-to-date political information. And I always know they're going to give it to me in a very, very fun and innovative way. Whether it's Rachel Maddow, whether it's Chris Matthews, whether it's the folks on the Dayside crew, whatever it is, I know MSNBC is there for me. Frankly, they're my new BFFs. What can I say?
So I'm David L. Cohen, Executive Vice President at Comcast, and we're here tonight celebrating the 15th birthday of MSNBC. It's been a great ride. If you think about it, 15 years ago, the average cable system had 47 channels. MSNBC was the first challenger to CNN News, and now fairly consistently beats CNN on its way to challenging Fox with these three major news channels. Maybe more impressive is what's happened in the broadband world. There was no broadband 15 years ago. There was no Google. There was no Skype. And in fact, the average use of the internet was 30 minutes a month, 1 minute a day. Today, the average use of the internet is up to 30 hours a month. And you can watch MSNBC on your television set. You can watch MSNBC on the internet. And you can watch MSNBC on your iPad. So just the multiple opportunities to enjoy the terrific content MSNBC puts forward has, I think, been transformative for the network. I think it's been transformative for the way in which the public consumes its news.
Yeah, what's going on in Congress? People need to realize there are just very few negotiators that are actually trying to strike a deal on the debt limit ceiling. So what we do are other things, which are just as important. However, that vote is going to be important. It's just a wait and see as to what kind of negotiated settlement you're going to get out of the parties and the president.
Of being out of politics, I miss it, and I'd be a liar if I said I didn't. Although I've found my post-governor's life to be challenging and energizing and good, it's not the same. It's like a basketball player who no longer can play the sport he loves. But on the other hand, I'm finding that because of my work with NBC, I'm still able to influence the public dynamic to a degree to participate in the national debate. And that's why I love what I do. Don't tell Phil Griffin, but I do it for a whole lot less money.
I'm Karen Finney with MSNBC. You know, I think in the case of the Keith Anthony trial, I mean, it is a newsworthy story and it is the job of the media to be there. I think some of the behavior that we saw, like people kind of fights breaking out for the limited number of tickets in the gallery, I don't think you can blame the media for that. I mean, those individuals who made the decision to travel that distance and wait in line for those tickets kind of tells you what a frenzy there was around this case. And again, I think the media really tried to stay as focused as possible on the case itself and the merits of the case and sort of that analysis. Some elements kind of went into more of the personal stories, But again, this was an item that was, I think, newsworthy regardless, and that the media was really just there to cover it.
I wish I had, especially given the last few days and all the media frenzy, I wish I had time to pay attention to the trial. So I didn't really pay that much attention to it. There certainly was a lot of media hype about it. There was a lot of commentary. Most of the commentary proved to be wrong. And, you know, obviously the defense lawyers felt beat upon for the last 30 to 60 days as everyone was saying that they didn't know what they were doing and they're representing a guilty person. And, you know, like or love the verdict, the defense attorneys obviously did a pretty good job. Fortunately, I think there may be a commentary on the sickness of the newspaper industry, and I think we're all bound and determined to make sure that the media industries and our content and our distribution business doesn't fall prey to the same fate. We have Chuck Todd. I don't think I missed anyone in the talent area. And I also want to acknowledge the attendance tonight of Antoine Sanfuentes, who is the head of the NBC Bureau, News Bureau here in Washington. So thank you all for joining us and for making MSNBC the extraordinary view that it is today.
With us longer than anybody else, he is the heart and soul of MSNBC.
You love the fact that there are people, tremendous of color and people from minorities and people that don't feel that other networks have spoken out loud about the concerns of the country. They come up to me all the time and say, we're so glad you're on television. It's a fact. It's a heartwarming reality.
I think there is plenty of balance, certainly on MSNBC, and I'm even willing to concede that there's balance on Fox as well.